Valve is replacing Nuke with Train in the active map pool for CSGO and will no doubt tweak it until it's popular and loved by all. But where does this leave Nuke? It's no secret that I, and many others, dislike Nuke in its current state. Every passage can be defended by CTs from about 20 different locations, making the terrorist side less about skill than it is about blind luck. I could have just pointed out the problems, but I've decided to go one step further and to actually change the map. I'm not saying that this will make the map perfect, or if the changes are even improvements, but at least I'm attempting change, which is the first step towards it. And a big change at that. First things first, I moved the spawn points the same distance forwards for both sides. It doesn't change the timings at all, it simply cuts out the 5 seconds of runtime at the beginning of each round, saving up to 2.5 minutes of boredom per game. There is no way that this is a bad thing. It will also make it better for deathmatch, since nobody likes spawning in these areas, plus the radar image can now show the most important middle area of the map in more detail. I got rid of as much of the roof area as I could. It's the T side of the map, so there's no reason for there being any players here. This also meant removing the vent opening. I would have loved to remove the roof section completely, but decided to keep the marshmallow boost spot because it's one of Nuke's defining features and adds a degree of skill to the navigation of the map. The outside area is one of the biggest changes. I moved this entire factory in the background across a bit since it's the perfect surface for both teams to bounce grenades off whilst on the run. I drastically repositioned the cover to help give the terrorists a better foothold in this outside courtyard. The CTs can still snipe, but it's a lot less open, meaning that they can't just slaughter terrorists as they rush out anymore. These crates are positioned in a way so that with 2 smokes, you can do a number of tactics. Yes, you can smoke up the 2 areas and get to secret, or you can try smoking close to CT spawn to gain access to the sniper's warehouse, or to bombsite A. Or you can block the view from heaven by landing a fancy smoke on the top of this red container here. I think that this will add a great deal more strategy to battles in this part of the map. I applied a planar metal texture to the inside of this warehouse, which makes snipers easier to spot and remove some of the hidey spots. All is not lost for CTs, however. Since terrorists will likely smoke up the courtyard, they'll be able to hide amongst the chaos and take T's by surprise. I can't wait to see what happens here and hope that it builds on some of the sneaky play that we used to see around the metal storage container in the old version. I didn't change bombsite A that much. I simply removed access to most of the rafters, meaning that CTs will be restricted to this wall. This should make the combat more about skill rather than lurking in a corner and shooting the first guy in the back. If I started changing the entire bombsite, then it really wouldn't be Nuke anymore. For now, I've kept it similar to the original in terms of ground layout, though I've moved the toxic barrels back to obscure vision between heaven and the hut, and have brightened up the vents a bit to make it easier to spot people inside. I removed some of the CT cover from ramp and added some more for the terrorists so that they can get to the area almost unseen. I'm still not completely happy with this room, but I'll wait and see how it plays out before changing it more, since it's hard to change the angles in this part of the map. Moving down to bombsite B, I've switched the ground to metal to make the sound clearer. Here is where I've made the other big change to the map. I joined this up to the side corridor that leads around B and reduced the number of entrances to the site by adding a wall here. This can be shot through easily, but will give attackers a choice of a concealed path to the site if they want it. I hope that leaving this area open will encourage the use of grenades. I also added diagonal walls to get rid of all the camping spots that were there before. This is more in line with how Valve has developed Overpass. I've kept Toxic, but have added a window and have removed one of the vent openings, but have centralized the remaining one to give it more cover behind the big Toxic thing. For the most part, I think the changes I've made at least have a bit of logic to them, but I like to add a wildcard when making maps, so I've added ladders to this site. They will further shorten the rotation times for the map, and may be something I deeply regret doing. But it should make the first stage of playtesting this map a lot more interesting. As mentioned in Adren's recent video, I have made it so that you have to crouch to get through this opening. I also threw in a load of crates to obstruct vision from CT spawn to courtyard. Will these changes make the map T-sided? I doubt it, but we'll just have to wait and see. I am very excited to see what differences these changes make to the gameplay. I know what you're thinking, these are radical changes. You could say that it's no longer Nuke. I think that if I saw this map on the workshop, even I'd think that the changes were excessive. But please, hear me out. I'm not proposing that all of my ideas will improve the map, but hopefully some of these changes will. Nuke in its current state is stagnant. There are evidently problems with the existing layout, and with it being removed from the active map pool, I don't expect Valve to do anything about it in the near future, short of a total overhaul. At least by throwing a load of new ideas in at once, it should serve as an interesting stepping stone towards the development of a new, better Nuke. I'm happy to try out things that other people suggest. It's not fair if I have all of the fun. If you are interested in giving this a go in its current state, check out the description where I'll post a link to the workshop, as well as any servers that may be running it. Maybe I'll see you there.